All right. What was interesting to me about that last video is that I thought it was going to go one way. That is, when I took a look at the question, and I actually really do know what I'm doing here. But it brings up an interesting fact that when you know the material really well and you just plug stuff in into a formula, you really lose sight of what you're doing. And I made a pretty big error in that last video where I thought it was going in one direction, but it actually was a very straightforward question. So if I have A is equal to B over C, if you notice, I isolated for C. And I prepped you guys for that skill, but we didn't use it. But anyways, I would multiply both sides by C. And then if I'm isolating for C, I would divide both sides by A. Let's see if I'm going to use that skill this time. Here we are. Here's a right-angle triangle. Now, it has to be a right-angle triangle in order to use these simple trigonometric ratios. I have a given angle. I'm going to call this theta. With respect to theta, this side is opposite. Now, here's my hypotenuse. Visually, I always pick out my hypotenuse, but the hypotenuse doesn't matter here. I'm not asked information about my hypotenuse. The next side I label is opposite. Why? Because it's the easiest. It's the side opposite. This is the adjacent side here. It's my non-hypotenuse side that's beside my angle. So now I've switched this up. Thankfully, we're no longer going to jump to the cosine ratio. I have to ask myself, what trigonometric ratio involves opposite and adjacent? And you could write, a lot of people like to write, so katoa, opposite and adjacent, well, it's going to be tangent. So I very carefully write tangent theta is equal to the opposite over the adjacent. And what happens here, we're going to plug in our information. So tangent of 57 degrees is equal to my opposite has a length of 14th. My adjacent is what I'm trying to find. The next step that I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply both sides by x. Now, I like it better when I think of tangent of 57, I put it in brackets. For some reason, it just helps me think about it a little bit more crisply. So tangent 57 times x is equal to 14. How do I isolate for x? Well, I have to divide both sides by tangent of 57 degrees. Now, what you may notice is that I haven't even touched my calculator yet. The tangent of 57, by the way, I'm just going to enter that in my calculator. The tangent of 57 degrees is some crazy number. It's 1.35986496 blah, blah, blah. That's a lot of baggage to carry around in a math question. That, and the instant that you write a decimal down, the information is less valuable. So instead, I'm going to leave it like this. And then in my calculator, I'm actually going to input this. If you are in the habit of finding the tangent of 57, writing that decimal down, please stop. So what I get is x is equal to 9.0917. I'm going to round to three decimal places. X is equal to 9.092. And that seems to make sense. This side is in the same ballpark as 14, same order of magnitude, right? 9 is close to 14, but visually it looks like a smaller side. Last but not least, this question here. So, first order of business, I would call this theta. Next order of business, I would label my triangle, hypotenuse, and the adjacent. Now, it's really quite sad we haven't done the last trigonometric ratio, which is sine. But it's the exact same thing, except for I would have the opposite side. So again, I'm going to be using tangent, because tangent ratio, tangent theta, is equal to, no, that's incorrect. I apologize. I'm looking for the trigonometric ratio that has hypotenuse and adjacent. This would be cosine. Cosine theta is equal to my adjacent over my hypotenuse. I'm going to simply plug in my formula. And multiply both sides by x. Then, to isolate for x, I'm going to divide both sides by the cosine of 64 degrees. And what I get, well, this number doesn't seem right, but then, how can it be wrong? Maybe we'll figure this out as we go along. Round to three decimal places, x is equal to 36.99. Notice I didn't put degrees because it's a side length. Now, does this make sense that this side is 36.499? Well, it is close to 16. It's three times larger. Visually, does x seem like it's three times or two times larger than the adjacent side? I would say yes. Also keep in mind that the hypotenuse has to be the largest side. So I actually think that this is good to go. Hopefully I didn't make a mistake. Best of luck solving for sides.